Welcome to Soft Reviewed. In this video, we are going to find out how we can use AI to write human-generated content. You heard me right. Now it's possible. I tested it myself, and what led me to that conclusion was like when I was reading this article, this seems interesting to me. Like a college student created an app that can tell whether AI wrote an essay, and this is the guy who created an AI detector so that he can stop students from using ChatGPT to write their assignments, and that's a big problem right now. Wanted to find a solution. What he created was like a new AI detector called GPTZero. I'll show you how it looks. This is that website. This is called GPTZero. It detects AI plagiarism accurately, and I have tested it like a lot of times. One thing I can say for sure, it's like it's working really well. This is a guy who created this AI detector. His name is like Edward Tien. As you can see, he's having many videos showcasing how this software works. And what's interesting is like in this article it mentions like how this AI detector works. So the main important point that you guys need to listen carefully is like how these are like the two main indicators that the software use: perplexity and burstiness. Perplexity measures the complexity of a text. If GPT-0 is perplexed by that text, then it has a high complexity and it's more likely to be human written. However, if the text is more familiar to the bot because it's been trained on such data, then it will be low complexity and therefore it's more likely to be AI generated. Separately, the burstiness compares the variation of sentences, and humans tend to write with greater burstiness. For example, some longer or complex sentence alongside shorter ones. AI sentence tends to be more uniform. So to test out this initial idea, what I did is like I prepared ChatGPT window using some instructions. First, I gave it this instruction, like, are you ready to follow some instruction for writing an article? So it came up with the answer, yes, I am ready to follow instruction for writing an article, and please go ahead with the instruction. So what I did was I just copied this this sentence and just pasted it here, like perplexity measures the complexity of the text. If GPT-0 is perplexed by the text, it has high complexity, and however it is the complexity because it's trained on such data, it will have low complexity. I gave a context of what perplexity and burstiness means. Then what I did, like I asked ChatGPT that I want you to write this next article with high perplexity and burstiness, do you understand? Then ChatGPT came up with the answer like, yes, I understand your instruction. I will write an article with high perplexity and burstiness. Please provide the topic or theme for the article. So then I gave, like, I tested like many articles, like 5 of them. Then I asked ChatGPT to write, like, please rewrite this article with some perplexity and burstiness. So I changed it to some because the higher it is, it's harder to read. So you can play around with this term, or you can change with high, low, medium, or anything that you want here. And one more neat trick is like you can, in order to avoid writing all these again and again, you can just come here and edit, and it will again generate a new article with high perplexity and burstiness kind of style. In order to show you guys, like, I will just copy this article that this article is also created using ChatGPT. So I'll just copy this article and I'll paste it to GPT-0 itself. I'll just paste it here and let's click on get results. And as you can see, it's saying that your text may include parts written by AI, and it's highlighting that particular text where it thinks it's written by AI. So that's a neat feature to have, which the paid AI detectors are even missing. Even originality won't show like where this particular article is AI written. So this free tool will highlight what part is AI written. And let's look at some other tools here. Like this is OpenAI's own AI detector. They just released it. I'll just copy paste it here and just click on submit, and let's see what it's classified. The classifier considered the text to be possibly AI generated, so it's also catching in that it's AI written content. Then we'll check with Copylex, is another free AI tool. It's also showing that it's AI detected, and I'll send it to originality just to be sure, and let's see what it comes up with. And 97% AI, and it's only 3% original. So the next step that I did is like I asked it to write like, please rewrite this article with some perplexity and burstiness, and I pasted this article that we just tested, and then it came up with this one. This is the one with the perplexity and burstiness, and let's just copy this text right now, and we'll again test it with the GPT-0 and see if it can detect. And it's showing that some part is sentences are like really written by AI, and it's highlighting that it's written by AI, but all the other tools are really failing to detect this. Okay, and that's what caught my attention to make this video. I'll just show you guys. I'll just copy paste this one, and I'll just click on check, and it's saying that it's human written content, right? And now let's open AI's own AI detector, and let's submit this newly written content, and it says it's unclear if it's AI generated. So it will not say for sure that it's human written, but it will only say like, I'm not sure if it's AI or human written content. Final, let's go to our paid tool like originality and see what it thinks. And it thinks like 98% original and only 2% is AI. In order to show you guys one more case study, I'll show you like how you can fool GPT-0 with the same strategy. And I asked it to rewrite different content. So I'll just copy this content that it rewrote to be sure. Like I'll show you like whether it's original or human written content. And as you can see, it's 100% AI. And now I'll show you like this one. I'll just scan with originality AI, and it shows like it's 100% original. Okay, the same I can just copy, and I can just ask GPT-0 also. Like I'll just refresh it. I'll just copy and paste it here, and just click on get results. As you can see, the text is likely to be written entirely by human. So this is how it will look, and you can see the perplexity score and burstiness score, and this is the main algorithm behind it. They use perplexity and burstiness. So this is what helped me to figure out ChatGPT to write human content. And if you guys want to follow along with those instructions, I will just copy paste this in the description below. So please check that out. This is something that you guys can try it out and let me know in the comments if it worked for you or not. Hope it was helpful. If you learned something new here, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe for more future AI related videos. And thank you for watching. Have a great day.